Hello everyone, welcome to Bed and Wash Day. Lovely. Got a bit of a stain on that, I think that's blood probably. So we've got, for our first load, a double duvet. I think this is 10.5 tog. Lovely, the lovely in the duvet. So that's okay. Suppose this is a great spring cleaner. I've been looking to do this for a while, so I have. So for the detergent, I've got about 80-ish ml of washing powder, which will go in, and I'm also going to stick in a wee tiny drop of sulfur, not too much. I think we'll do cotton 60, medium soil, 233. Hopefully I'll manage to get it all washed. Decided for 1 hour 48, and I never thought I'd see the day where it fucks off like that. So they blasting all the washing powder on. getting that soaked nicely, so it is. Still main washing, so we are. It's temple, and so it is. It is at 60. Washing very nicely, so it is. for its final rinse now. Spin. Unfortunately, it has limited to 800, I think. I don't know, the final spin went really weird on it, so it did. I've noticed sometimes whenever it's doing its balancing for the final spin, it sometimes like does like a really long 200 RPM stage. So it does, most of the times it doesn't, but the odd time it does, and it's done it there and I, so it has. I never really gave it a chance to balance, so it didn't, it just went for it, and it's being an unbalanced spin, so it's limited. Can't really comment on limiting, like, what it's like yet. The first few weeks, it didn't limit at all, but I've noticed it's being limited in here and there now, so it is. But it isn't bothering me, so it isn't at the moment, so I don't think I'll respin this.
I think if it was to go to full speed with an unbalanced spin, my car would be shaking quite a bit. It's a very light washing machine, so it is very light. So it does shake quite a bit whenever it's unbalanced. Got a deep in a mattress topper waiting. I don't think I'll get them in all in on the one wash in this, so I don't. But we'll see. I just brought the mattress topper down because why not? I might wash it with a pillow instead if it's quite full with the duvet. I'm in a wee bit of a rush, I think, so I don't really know what wash to stick it on. I don't know whether to stick it on medium soil or low soil. It's nowhere near as dirty as what this one was, but it's just like, do I want to be certain that it heats to 60 or not? But timing is a hard thing. I might just stick it on full length, to be honest, because this is going to be in the dryer for quite a bit anyway. I'll see how wet it is. I might give it a respin, I don't know. I'm quite short on time, and I need to get it done today. Suppose the real question for me is, like, will the respin do much? What to do, to be honest. I think I'll just leave it. It's not soaking, so it's not. I don't want to stick it on a respin and then potentially have it, you know, limit again. So I'll just stick it in the dryer the way it is. It's not soaking. It span for at 800 for quite a bit. So it did. Quite a bit of glare from that sun there. So yeah, this duvet isn't, I don't think there's really like any marks on it, so I don't. I reckon it'll probably be only this duvet that'll fit in. This is a single duvet, 10.5 tog, I think. I'm not exactly sure the sizing of that one. See there. No, I'm not going to stick a mattress topper in with that. I think I will stick this one in low soil just because of the material off it. I want it on a 60 wash, but I don't really want that one to be washing at 60 for too long. It's like a, I don't know. I don't really want to say cheaper, but I think it's like a cheaper material. I need to turn that. So we'll do cotton 60 with low soil. I think it only takes like this is a hard one. You know, I'll stick my detergent in and then I'll decide on it. Cause the real thing is that it's gonna be waiting on the dryer, so it is. Because imagine, well, the dryer's normally on for about 2 hours or so with them anyway. That one's quite a lighter duvet, so I think I'll stick in the rest washing stuff with it. I don't want it to go crazy with foam, so I don't want it foam padding. Let's see, how much is that? I think that's a wee bit less. I think that's about 65-70 mil, which I'm happy with. I think I'll stick it on medium actually, so we'll do 1600 medium soil again. Washing powder's all in, that's fine. So 1600. Let's go. It should sense the same time, I reckon. I suppose it's a difference of 30 minutes. Should really go and get this in the dryer. Oh, I'll just wait until it's done sensing. Doesn't take that long with it. Yep, 1 hour 48 again. Upstairs with the dryer now. So let's stick this in here. I don't want to bung it up too much. Ow! Didn't mean to do that. All in loosely, okay. Make sure nothing's trapped under that. It's okay. Yep. Ground. Go stick in a wee dryer sheet just to use them up. And it goes with the softening too. I think it's good to use them with that softener before it's also done. So there's our dryer sheet there, all in. Mother tank hasn't really got anything in it, so that's all okay. We will do duvet, extra dry. Let's get going. It'll be on for quite a bit, so it will. So I'll leave the poor dryer to do its thing all day. Well, really get filming this wash not much. I was in the shower, so it was so I got to 60 at like 1 hour 20 left. Yeah, so it got to 60 at about 1 hour 20 left, so it did. So it washed at 60 degrees for like 40 minutes. Probably would have been better off sticking it on low soil, but oh well. Seems just washed it well, so it has. It got quite sudsy, so it did, but I think the suds died down in the end, thankfully. But it's on the final spin now, so it is. Hopefully it won't limit this time. Might have this difficulty balancing that though, of the way it's all bunched up. very bright day today. I think this will probably be you for the last wash of the day, and then we'll do the rest of it outside. I think I'll do some videoing for this tomorrow as well. I don't know if I'll take out this 1600 if it goes for that. I think I might rebalance, yeah, this. Yeah, it's coming to the game. It's not giving itself much of a chance at all, the Bombs. Okay, I'm gonna go and get my water for outside sorted. Yes, I am. So, I'll probably be back whenever this is done, just. Yep, so, done now. Doesn't feel that wet, to be honest, because of how thin it is. Is also finished, so it was lovely. Feels dry. There's a dryer sheet somewhere amongst this that I'm gonna have to find. But yeah, I will get that loaded and stuck into the dryer now. Dryer's all cleaned out. Go stick it onto the seam. Cycle. Big duvet in. No, single duvet. Stick to my plans. It's all fine. Cleaned out all the filters and stuff, so. Okay, we're outside now with Mila, so I'll turn it on. I've got two pillows that need washed, so we do. One of these pillows says do not wash, and then the other one says to hand wash only. So I think, I know it would be better to wash them on a 60 wash, But I'm not going there just because of the fact that I don't want to ruin the pillows, so I want to make absolute sure that they don't come out ruined. So we're gonna just do them on a 4-day wash with a slow spin. So the pillows, these ones have a few blood stains on them. So they do. Stick in this other one. Very awkward doing this with me sticky on my tripod, just because I need both hands really, so I do. It's very windy today, we have storm cowling here, I think it's called that. So it's very fun, you know. Right, so got it all loaded in, so we have, that's grand. I'm gonna take it back off my tripod now. Well, it probably would have been a better idea to pour the detergent first before I've done that, but not sure. So just seeing the detergent is inside. That would be fine, but 60 mil. It's okay. Over here, and then that door's gonna be a wee bit annoying, isn't it? Very hard to see. Open the door. The door keeps on shutting itself. Yep, so that's it up to 35, so rinse and softener. I think it left a wee bit of softener in it yesterday, so it did, hence why the water is that colour in the softener drawer. It's not dirt. So it's not, that door keeps on opening, closing, so annoying. So that's okay. See what I mean? These shed doors are rubbish. I don't know, white pillows. My problem with pillows is the internal spins and stuff like that. How long is it with extra gentle? 1 hour 26. Let me see. I was thinking about minimum iron 40 with extra gentle. That's 150. Decisions. If I had to being honest, I would have used delicates, but the problem with delicates is that it doesn't allow much time at all to drain out the water, and it typically goes into the next rinse with suds left in it. You know what? We'll do pillows, extra gentle. 4,800. That's grand. Do that. So there's the friction spin. Because at least that gives it time to drain out the suds and stuff. It would be good if I could prop something against that door so it wouldn't bang about. That's gonna get annoying throughout the video, isn't it? I wish I could just sit in my shed with my doors closed and have my light on, but the flickering's even worse. I wish I could have more windows on my shed, to be honest. Anyway, I'll leave me go to do its thing, so I will. Migo's still washing away. I got the door sorted, so it's not going to bang about anymore. Also got Migo Professional all sorted too, so I did. We will be using it as well, so I will. I haven't used this machine in ages. So I haven't. So today most of the loads will be done in probably in the Migo W1, the Migo Professional. And then tomorrow we'll probably use like maybe W1 and we'll also be using this. So it's just a busy, busy, busy. I do wish I could use more power at once in my shed, so I do, but it is what it is. It doesn't bother me too much. It would just be handy, you know, to be able to use like say like a washing machine and a dryer in here at the same time. I think that's the biggest inconvenience to me, but here I could be running everything in my shed off an extension lead and I'd rather not do that, so much happier that I've got electrics in here. It's quite a nice day, to be honest, aside from the wind. Nice day for washing. It's got quite a low water level in it, but it's, you know, it's washing absolutely fine. My temperature gun is somewhere out here. Class is at 35. I think it's finished heating, so it has a wee bit of go. So it's just doing gentle wash action now. So it is. don't know what it is. It's turning heater on and off. Quite a delicate wash. With the fact that extra gentle is on. Needed it to be, you know, really delicate. Seems to be using power wash quite a bit now too, which is nice. So I think it's got about 20 minutes left on its main wash. And then once it's finished its main wash, we'll stick that onto a drum clean just to freshen it up. And then by that time, this one will probably be done once that's finished its main wash, so I can stick another load on in this. And then we'll stick a load into that. I had an issue with this wee one where it wasn't turning on straight away for some reason, but today I've turned it on at the wall there now and it seems to be fixed, which is weird, really weird. It's nice that the water pressure is all working fine on that, so it is. I had that turned off at the pipe, so I did the water for it, so I had to move the dryer, so I did to get to it, and that was fun. Especially all the washing machines on today. Jammed my arm quite a bit. Sick. So yeah, washing basket's fun. So it is really fun. Milo's on its second rinse with pillows. And I've stuck the professional on Cotton's Hygiene 95 with water plus. I haven't used it in a while, so I want to get it all, you know, freshened up. The inside, it's nearly at temp. So what we'll do is we're going to wash two more pillows and then we will leave, what do you call it, so we'll wash two more pillows and then we will leave three pillows and a mattress topper to wash tomorrow. So we will. I wouldn't have the time to get it all done today, so I wouldn't. It's not really the washing that's the issue, it's getting them dried, so it is. Because I can only have the Grundig on inside. I can't have any dryers on out here while the washing machines are on. So I can't. So far it's used 0.6 kilowatts and 40 litres of water. It's been quite efficient on this cycle. But thankfully it isn't dry rinsing, which is nice. I think I might actually like grilled meal now, to be honest. Because it is able to work properly. I can't see it ever coming back into the house, like, but if I like it outside of my shed, then that's good enough for me. More than good enough for me. I think it would annoy me more if I was running out of space desperately in my shed and I had a washing machine that I'd brought brand new and I couldn't use it at all sitting there. I didn't have the space for something else I really wanted. But I can use it now and it works well, so yeah. I'm enjoying using it now. Only does a wee short burst on pillows, but it's better than nothing and it gives it time to drain out all the suds and stuff, so this should be it going on the final rinse now. This one finished eating. Yeah, it's at 90. Steam coming out of it. Don't know if the camera, well, the camera's picking it up there. Very nice. So yeah, that's the rinse levels it's doing on this wash, but it's not bad at all. So it is. It's much better than what it was doing. Onto it so it's cooling.
episode has.
I need to shake them outside, eh? lovely. Might better bring these inside then. So David, that was in here, came out nice and dry. I'm just taking it out, so I think we managed to fix them. Yes. So they're nice and in shape again. That's grand. Dryer sheet, dryer sheet, dryer sheet. That's good, so plus I'll have to stick them on timer once it's done. It never finishes with these dry, so it doesn't. Okay, so I've went and changed the plan a wee bit, so I have. So I've got some bedding. I've got bedding and a bath mat in here because of the fact that I have a tiles wash today and I want to do that on 90. And the bath mat can't be washed at 90, so hey, may as well just chuck it in here. So, full load, double set of bedding, sibs, and a single set of bedding. All in. So, we've got our aerial washing powder, around about 100ml in there. So, I'll put in the fabric softener after, which will be that Glenora again. Just because this wee machine has a habit of filling through the softener compartment whenever it's not meant to. So, and can take it in early. So, what wash do we want to do? Just having a wee nosy. Does it have bedding? No. I have to say cycles, but no. We'll do Cotton's Universal with 60 degrees with intensive and water plus 1 hour 32. That's a brand. Let's go. I wanted to stick a mattress topper in with this wash, but it doesn't fit, so I couldn't. Water plus is set so that it's just extra water, no extra rinse. It's the extra rinse on this machine's a bit rubbish. And it's rubbish because of the spin that it does. Must have been like, I wanted to stick it on like a 65 degree wash. But that's what I was looking for bedding. But I think whenever I'd done that, I must have used like Tylenol or something. So that's it filling up. I'm taking in the wash and stuff. I don't know if it will reduce the time or not. I'm hoping it will, but it might not. I can't remember if I explained the change of plan. I was gonna wash two more pillows today. But what I've decided today is I'm going to leave them till tomorrow. So tomorrow I'll have 5 pillows to wash and that mattress topper. And I also have a basket of washing that needs done. I think once this is finished, its main wash, I will bring some of the washing outside and I'll stick some of it in the mirror, so I will, in that one. So yeah, it's all fun. But hectic. And then I'll do like the towel washing stuff tomorrow, so I will. Wash time down to 1 hour 13. Seems to be happy with its.
It's water usage.
It has pretty much taken all the washing stuff in, so it has. As you can see, a wee tiny bit of water went into that apartment, so it has. It dribbles into it, so it does, and it shoots into it if you open the drawer. So I don't put fabric softener until the last rinse, pretty much. Sticking in a wee bit more water. Seems to have reached temp now, so it has. Door glass is at 56. I've brought some more washing out, so I have. This will be my last load for today. So it will be, and we'll do it in the mirror W1. Don't know what to do about drying these loads like. I would dry them out here or what. No, definitely at least one of them will be dried out here. Grundig's still working away. I put that thing free some torture, I tell you that much. Seems to just be doing normal action with this load rather than the fast ramp up tumbles to distribution. But still washing nicely, so that's the main thing. Apologies about the wind that you can probably hear on the video blowing into the camera mic. Once this starts to drain, I will stick the W1 on, so I will. Let's turn the heater back on. Tell you what, it's been such a nice day for washing, so it has. Really nice day. Okay, so Mega Professional has 30 minutes left. It's coming towards the end of its main wash. I'd like to go on the first spin, about 5 minutes. So we will move up and get W1 stuck on. It's really just everyday clothes, so it is, and some pajamas and stuff like that. I've noticed that they've made the beep for it. I'm really quiet whenever turning the machine on. It doesn't seem to be possible to change the tune anymore whenever you the welcome tone, which is really weird. But okay. Let's see. So. I just want to make sure that there's definitely nothing in these pockets. Yep, that's okay. So we've got our washing on. I haven't got too much washing in that, so I haven't. So we can shut the door. Don't know whether to just stick it on Cotton's 40. I wouldn't like to think that it would detect that as being a fill load. I can't see it. I don't know. Let's see. We'll stick it on the quick power wash. 40, 1600, 1 hour 15. I'm just gonna stick in washing powder because I don't really want to go inside. I can be bothered. Getting tired, but for a second. While I sort this out. Get all this detergent sorted out, you can watch me go.
That sounds awful.
Softener and stuff. It's okay. And washing powder, I've got about 70 mil. So quick power wash, 40, 1600, 1 hour 15 minutes. Gotta love how even whenever two machines are filling up, it's still higher than what my water pressure was like. Taking it in real quick. Oh, sounds absolutely awful. Goodness. Never heard of this bad app before, so ever. See, there's quite a bit of water in that now. Final rinse. Thank you. think I might just buy a new belt first and then maybe not use it tomorrow. Maybe just use the mirror in the crater. See. I think it's just that belt signed in so rough, I'm a bit concerned I could fall off. I've heard it's up here and there, but not like that. You know. I have other amigo belts here, but I don't know if it would fit it. I just finished doing the second detergent mixing stage, so it did. It's now back to heating, but I think it's nearly up temp, to be honest. Maybe not. I think all that bedding's actually tangled up. This is gonna be fun. Sorry, I wanted to check the time, so I did. Where's the drum light? I wish I could have the drum light working on this. I said on Instagram quite a while back that I was getting the wire that I needed for it, but Mila changed their call centre thing so that if you want to buy anything from them, you have to phone them, pretty much. And I was like, nah, I don't want to do that, so I will live without a drum light for the time being. So I will. I'm sure I'll get one. I'm sure I'll get the wee wire I need at some point, like, but crap happens, and it's still working, so I suppose that's the main thing. Spun them well, so it has. Perfect. Back of the drums, nice and hot. So, I think that's time for me to bring them inside then. Lovely. So that's the bedding and stuff waiting on the dryer now. I had to stick the Grundig on for an extra hour with the pillows just because of the way they are. They never come out dry and they need ages to get them out dry. But this has got 38 minutes left. I think for the video format, I'm thinking I'm gonna make it maybe a 3-part series rather than have like a 6-hour long video or something like that. I done a mini wash day yesterday with the Mega and the Credo where I was doing 2 loads of washing, and then I've had today where we've been doing bedding and stuff like that. Then I'll have tomorrow where I'm doing the rest of the bedding and some other stuff. So I think I might make it into a 3-part thing. I think I'd quite like to do that, to be honest. It makes it a bit easier for me rather than having like 60 cuts to sort through. Yeah, I think I'll do that. So well, and then I'll have all the stuff linked down in the description, like the other parts, so that it's simple enough to find. Tomorrow we'll probably use Mila and the Creta, to be honest. I don't know about this. Sometimes it sounds worse than other days. Weird. I don't know. I haven't used that since the time that I, you know, said about it going wrong. I done an ID wash and that was it. It's kind of just collecting dust now, so it is. Which is quite sad for me. Just checking. get on the tripod for a wee bit just because my legs are getting a bit sore. I need to stand up. Well, that's the day where brick bar wash works, I guess. I could get that for a water level. Max rent level isn't even on. Well, let's see the day where it would rinse with that much water by itself. I feel like I'm living in luxury. restricted access water in it. It seems like it's draining out a lot better too than what it was in the house. Because it looked like that definitely would have sudsocked on this wash. That's a totally different machine, it's amazing. So much better. I think I'm just gonna film the rest of this wash, to be honest. For yous, I'll be kind. We got 12 minutes left, so suppose I may as well be kind to yous. I'm just absolutely shocked at what a difference high water pressure has made for me. I don't have to worry about any machines I get, whether they work with the water pressure or not. I don't have to worry about anything anymore. It's amazing. Like before, I was worrying about two machines filling up together, especially if it was like a meal or something. Whereas now, I just don't have to worry at all anymore. Oh, it's amazing. So, so nice. ends up spending quite a bit of time balancing, then just goes for the most unbalanced attempt on the limits. At least that's the only thing that I guess I don't like about it. It doesn't dry rinse and stuff anymore. That's amazing. Quite interesting that even out here with the Wi-Fi signal being so bad, that I still get notifications for the washing machine, so I do. Look at that for water usage. That's impressive. I was lucky, sometimes I get that much of a full load. Oh, amazing. So we're gonna take this out now and stick it all into this dryer up above the Beko. I don't wanna get anything on the floor. As I do that. Dryer sheet in the dryer, so I do, which is nice. Stuck to drum. Perfect. That's lovely. That is amazing. I think I actually like my hood again. Oh, fantastic. I'm just really so happy I can use that again. Really am. So I've got it all loaded up into drawer, so I have. I need to move that to the other side because I need to unplug the Mego and in the dryer. Where's this one? So stick it on. I think I'm gonna use low temp, to be honest, just to be on the safe side, as it is a condenser dryer. There's a few light things in it, so low temp, 70 minutes. Let's go. So I think that officially marks the end of the video. 9:25 now, so it is. Been a really good day for washing, and the Hoover H4700 and the two Megas. The bedding's still waiting to go on in the dryer inside, but I probably won't film that, so I won't. I'll just stick that on Cotton's Cover Dry Plus or Cotton's Extra Dry. So I will. So part one, which is mini wash day, will already be up by the time that this is going up. What date's this filmed? I just want to check. So, Mini Wash Day was filmed on 5th of April. Then this is filmed on the 6th of April. And then tomorrow's video that I'll be recording, at the time of me filming this tomorrow, will be April 7th. So, well, isn't that right? Yeah, tomorrow's April 7th, so... So I'll have them all uploaded in order and three parts. So I will for each of the 3 days. Don't really know what machines we'll be using tomorrow, to be honest. I'll hopefully be using the Frida. Hopefully. But yeah, it's been a really fun one. I'm just so happy at this machine. Honestly. I was so disappointed in it with, I think it was mainly the way that it worked with the water pressure, to be honest. As I was just so annoyed at the fact that a 200 pound washing machine couldn't work with it. Could work with it, sorry. And this really, really expensive machine couldn't. But it's working now, so I don't have a problem with that anymore. So we'll see how that goes. So we will. But yeah, thank you all so much for watching, everyone. Really hope that you enjoyed. And I'll have both of them, part 1 and part 3 is in the description below. Once part 3 is out. Thank you all so much for watching, everyone. Goodbye.